Okay, welcome to the micro engineering course. We start here with the modes of operation. We say that there are the various modes of operation that modes of operation for a given material, that is called as a transfer electron device. Modes of operation, we have gun oscillation mode, stable amplification mode, LSA mode, bias circuit oscillation mode. And in that gun oscillation mode, we say transient time domain mode, delayed domain mode, and quench domain mode. So here, if you see the figure, we say that this is about a transient time mode, a delayed mode, quench domain mode, and a LSA mode there. Now, in this case of a LSA mode, if you see that FL, that will be greater than 2 into 10 to the power 7 centimeter per second. Okay, that is about a FL. So for a LSA mode. And so we need to learn about what happened to this particular LSA mode. So we have seen that for the different modes, what will be the LS and all. We have seen. So now if you consider the different domain, so that domain means what? That domain, it forms the domain and then it will disappear. So formation of a domain means we say that electron travel from this negative to the positive. So then domain formation takes place and then it will be disappear. Okay, that we have seen. So means generally we say that electron travel there. So that's why we say that domain does not travel. Okay. So we will not say that domain does not travel. So we say that domain formation takes place because of that electron travel. So that's why we say that generally we say that it is domain travel. No, it is only we say that electron travel from the cathode to anode. So that's why a domain formation takes place. And when we say that this about the domain formation takes place and domain disappear because electron move from the cathode to anode, so that's why that it disappears. But it occurs whenever that device will work in the that condition is about what? About that whatever the bias we apply about that particular electric field. Now if you consider this particular domain, in this particular case here. So for the transit time domain, for the delayed mode, for quench domain mode, or this particular domain mode. So then operating frequency for each and every domain is different. So now if we consider that a quench domain mode or a delayed mode, so the operating frequency is different. Okay. So in this particular case, operating frequency is different. But if we consider that LSA mode here, the operating frequency is higher. Okay. So that we consider that gun oscillation mode or a gun domain there. Okay, all these are nothing but what we can say that is about the gun domain mode. But in this case, operating frequency is higher. This particular quench domain mode, in this particular quench domain mode, operating frequency is higher. So now you see that here it end. That's why operating frequency is higher than that of whatever we can say that is about a delayed mode. Okay, so this is about a delayed mode. So that's why here the operating frequencies are. And if you compare the LSA mode, this LSA mode, so again the LSA mode, that operating frequency is higher. Okay. So because of that high operating frequency, so this particular device, that is about we say LSA mode, or we can say that a LSA diode. So that is nothing but what? LSA mode means what? We say it is about a limited space charge accumulation in mode. Limited space charge accumulation in mode. Okay, that is about a LSA mode. So now if you consider this LSA mode, so its frequency is higher. Okay, that is about we say as compared to the delayed mode or a quench domain mode. But this particular LSA mode, its frequency is higher. And again we say that efficiency. Okay, if we consider that the efficiency, that is nothing but for this particular mode, it is about a 20% efficiency. And it provides a high power. Okay, means you will get that high power output. And we say this particular LSA mode will be operate as operation takes place in the case of what we can say that is about the gun domain process. Okay, or you can say that is about a gun domain. So this mode of operation is called as a, what you can say, that is about a Gunn oscillator mode of a operation there. Now in this particular case, if you see that what happened here, that is about the domain formation takes place. Earlier we say that, but in this particular mode, so domain will not able to form in this LSA mode. Okay, so we can say that here we say that is about a domain occurs in all the cases here, but it's about in domain will not be allowed to form here in this particular LSA mode there. And if you see the frequency and the voltage for this particular application and all, so all these things we say that is about a voltage and all. So this work, that is, this will work above the threshold voltage. If we say that is about a, this one is about a threshold voltage, your LSA mode will work above this particular threshold voltage there. And that's why we can say that because of that above the threshold voltage, then we say a current start decreases. So that we say that is about the domain formation takes place and your device will work in a negative resistance region there. But in general, we say here it is about a peak formation takes place here. Okay, we say that is about a VTH occur, current will be changes here. But this device works with a high bias, high operating voltage. So this particular peak will be changes. Okay, so naturally we say for a given particular device or particular material, this is about a fixed drift velocity or a current, we say, but this may vary. Okay, this may vary. Why this may vary? Because of that avalanche breakdown occur in this particular device there. And again, a Gunn oscillator, these are nothing but a mode here. Okay, and if you consider that, that's why we say that about a Gunn oscillator, we say it is work for the micro frequency. Okay, this is about a mode here. We say that this particular work at a micro frequencies, or it generate a micro frequency there. Okay, it generate a micro frequency. We say that this one about a Gunn oscillator. And what about the this Gunn oscillator work at a micro frequency? And we say that with the compound use is about a gallium arsenide. And this particular gallium arsenide compound, or we can say that is about a cadmium telluride. Okay, these are about the compound we can use, or indium phosphide, that particular compound we can use. And this particular compound, so we say here it will work for the given particular frequency range, and it will work for the high power. Okay, we'll get that high power, and this particular device can be easily connected to the whatever the micro integrated circuit there. Now we'll learn about a how we can construct a Gunn diode. That is about a construction of a Gunn diode. The construction of a Gunn diode, just like we have a simple diagrams here for this construction of a Gunn diode there. We'll have to draw the diagram for this one. Okay, so we have a top here. This one is about the top for the Gunn diode here. Then say this one, okay. This one is about if you remember that how to draw the diagram for this particular Gunn diode and all, but right now if you see that we need to learn about that how this Gunn diode works and all. Okay, this one is about a gold wire you consider here. This is about a too big I have drawn here. One is about too big, what we can say that is about the top cap. This one is about it. Sorry, this one is about a gold wire, we say. Then this one is about a ceramic paper. This one we consider that is about the epitaxial gallium arsenide device with SN content. Okay. And then this one is about it, we can say it is about a gold plated molybdenum substrate. Okay. Likewise. One is different here, particularly we say, and this one is about a ceramic. And in general, if you consider that, that is about a construction details. So now you can say that this one is about a gold alloy. This one is about the gold alloy. Small fixture, that's about a conducting one. Let's say that, say we have the gold wire here. And this one is about a pin dot. This is about a flange. About a flange for this particular case, so that it will be closed now. And then these are nothing but a contact. We have the contact here, and active layer we have. Then this one becomes a contact, and this is nothing but a gold plated. This one is a gold plated molybdenum substrate. This one is a contact. Okay, contact here. And this one is about your active layer. And everything is about your, this one is about a gold alloy. Okay. Is about a, everything is about a gold alloy. So that is about a construction of, we can say that is about a gun diode here. So how your diode is there, how it looks like. So this one, this one will work, and this way we are getting the high frequency output. Okay, so it act as a oscillator there. So next device we will learn here, that is about a trapper diode or a impact diode here. So we learn, we try to learn first, and that is about the impact diode. So impact diode means what here? It is about the impact ionization avalanche transit time device. Impact, okay. Avalanche. Transit time device. Okay, so this one is nothing but we say impact. That is about the impact impact means what? This one, impact ionization. So that's why we say here we have A for avalanche, T for transit. Okay, so this T time is about it. Whatever we can say that a transit time device. So that is about the impact ionization, IMP, that is for the impact ionization, avalanche, transit time device. So that is about, or we can say that device, or we can say it is a diode now. So generally we say that a micro device work in a negative resistance region, and they have some delay between that voltage and current. In an avalanche diode, in this particular avalanche transit time devices, what happened here? So that there will be delay, but there will be avalanche. That avalanche delay plus avalanche, that will be with the whatever the time we are. Okay, avalanche with respect to the whatever the transit time we are throughout this particular material. So that's why you can say that this particular device is called as a avalanche transit time device. So we learn here the impact ionization one. So here impact ionization effect occurs. That is about how that impact ionization occur. We say your device work. That is about a device work in what? Okay, device works in negative resistance region. Okay, this device will work in a negative resistance region. Then again, because of that negative resistance region, this device, okay, it has two effects. That two effects means what? So that we say that the impact ionization avalanche effect that causes the carrier current and whatever the voltage we have, so that will be of a out of phase. Okay, that's what we say, current and a voltage, that will be a out of phase. That is about out of phase means about a 90 degree, that is out of phase by 90 degree. So we say here whatever the carrier current we have and whatever the AC voltage we applied, that will be of a out of phase. And again, second thing is what we say, that is about impact avalanche ionization. Okay, this one is about the impact ionization avalanche. In that case, carrier current and what you can say, that is about the AC voltage will be out of phase by 90 degree. In the case of a transit time effect, this is about this effect. Then we need to learn about a transit time effect. In transit time effect, so that transit time effect will delay the current, and that will be that whatever the current we say, whatever the we have learned, that whatever the current we apply, or you can say that is about the external current now. So that's about it. We say it's about a transit time effect. In a transit time effect, we say that is about the external current. That will be delay, okay. Okay, so we can say that it will delay that external current, okay. And what will happen? That will be delayed, and that will be relative to the AC voltage of by phase of a 90 degree. So that is about, you can say that will, okay, external current will be delayed, and that delayed one, that will be relative to the AC voltage by the 90 degree, okay. That is about the AC voltage by the 90 degree. So that is about, we say here, these are about the when your device work in this negative resistance region. This one is about, we say, a current and voltage delay occur in the micro diodes. The same thing here we are saying, but we are relating that what happened to the impact ionization there and what happened to the transit time there. So means total voltage and current, if you consider that, so in the total will be what? There will be a 180 degree phase shift. And that, because of that 180 degree phase shift, so we can say that this diode, whatever we say, impact diode, okay, this one is about the impact diode, will work in this particular negative resistance. Okay, so that is about a simple say, how your micro diode phase work in a negative resistance region and all. Okay, simply because of that total particular phase is about the 180 diode. So that is about due to the delay and due to delay in a current and a voltage, or how that delay in a current and voltage occurs because of that impact ionization avalanche, and we can see that is about the transit time effect. So that is about your impact diode. Now if you see the schematic of the impact diode, so it is just like it is a junction of what p-type material and n-type material. But it is not only a p-type and n-type, it is about the, it has the impurity, added impurity there. So that's why I say that it's about the p plus and a n plus there. So we consider that the schematic of this particular impact diode. See here, section here we have the sections we say draw now, and this one is about the section for the n plus drift region. Okay, so this is about your cathode. We'll apply the voltage here. We are applying 400 kV per centimeter now. Okay, now, and this one is about the anode here. This one is about the cathode. So this one we say it is about the P plus, and this one is about the N plus. Now in P plus we say, but the anode, since it is the anode, okay, so that's why it is about a negative one. So since it is about a cathode, so dopant and a concentration, if you consider that highly dopant, so that's why we say that is about a sign of a plus here. This is about a your impact diode. Is nothing but a contact to this particular device P junction. This is nothing but a one particular junction we say, and this junction here, so it has what we can say the region, and that is about a P plus N. So this device, earlier we say that is about a gun diode will work at a high when we apply the a field. Okay, electric field higher than a threshold voltage, then it will exhibit, or the diode will work in a negative resistance. Similarly here, this particular diode will work for higher voltage. So this will work for the higher voltage, that is about the 400 kilovolt per centimeter. So that's why we say that this particular diode will work with a high voltage, as well as we can say it will work in a high current there. But if you consider the normal diode, in the normal diode, that breakdown occur easily. Okay, so in a normal diode, what happened? So when we apply the bias, so we can say that is about the breakdown occur. But in the case of impact, that is about a background, we can say that breakdown in this particular normal diode occur quickly. But in the case of this particular impact diode, it will be constructed in such a way that that breakdown condition will be occur by applying that high voltage there. Okay, that is about, we can say by applying the high bias, or we can say that by applying the high potential voltage to the particular diode, then in that case when we apply this high voltage, then because of that applying high voltage, so then a carrier will move. You can say that minority carrier will move across this particular junction. So now minority carrier will move across this particular junction when we apply the high voltage or a high bias voltage. So this device will work with a high voltage, or you can say that the bot it will work for the high current. Okay, this is about your p-n junction diode. For a normal diode, okay, breakdown we can say that is about quickly it occur. But if you consider that impact diode, in the case of impact diode, we require that high voltage there. Okay, we require the high bias, or you can say that is about the high voltage. Even if we further increases the bias there, so then what happened there? So further increase the bias, so breakdown easily occur, and then flow minority carrier, okay, so it will flow and then that we can say that about the current is propagating. So means electron are moving, electron are flowing through this particular region. So when electron are flowing through this particular region, so then what happened here? Electrons move from that, or holes are move from that particular region. Means velocity of that electron and hole will produces what? Additional electrons and holes. Okay, because we say that if given particular structure, if given particular material, because by applying the high bias voltage or high voltage and high current, so when we increase the hole velocity, okay, we say that when we increase the bias, or we can say that when we apply some particular bias there, so in that case, that bias will be more than that whatever the expected value, initial value, or a DC bias required for this particular diode. When it will be increases, that velocity of electrons and holes will increases, and that produces because of that increase in velocity. Okay, because of increase in velocity of what we can say that is about the electron and hole. Because of increase in electron and hole here, so what will happen? It will generate that additional electron, additional electron and a hole here. So that is the factor. Because why it generate additional electron and hole? Because a structure, or you can say that is about a material we are using, and because of those material, impact ionization takes place inside the given device or given particular structure or a lattice. So because of that impact, because increase in velocity means electrons and holes, they will produce additional electrons and holes, because that effect is called as a impact ionization. Because of that, there will be additional electrons and holes, or you can say that a additional carrier generated, and then that additional carrier continues to process the whatever at that particular junction. Okay, so these are about additional holes. Similarly, we say that is the word we can say that is about the additional carrier. Okay, additional carrier that will be continue to process the at that particular junction. And because of this processing all the additional carrier at this particular junction, then okay, so we can say that is about a, we say it looks like all this carrier, okay, whatever additional carrier reaches that particular junction, and that particular junction it's just like a snowball effect, and that occur in that particular at the particular junction. So and that effect with the, we say that is about called as a avalanche. Okay, so that is about, we can say, a avalanche. Now if in the case of when we apply, okay, if we apply the original DC field to the given particular impact diode, okay, this region. So if supposed to be some particular DC field we apply or give the some particular DC field, and that field is at what we can say that is about a threshold voltage. So what will happen to this particular case? Or if it go beyond it, then avalanche action takes place. If it is at a some particular threshold value of voltage, then what happen? So that we say that at this particular with that particular field, okay, at a particular threshold value of voltage, so your device will start work. If it go beyond that, or if we exceed that particular value, then we say that the avalanche takes place, or we can say that avalanche current multiplication takes place in that particular device. So we can say that avalanche multiplication process, which we say that additional electron, additional carrier, that's additional electrons and additional carriers, we say that's about them, occurs when we have the positive RF cycle. And then we say that avalanche current multiplication will be takes place in that particular period of time. This particular avalanche process, or you can say that multiplication process, in we say that the avalanche will not be instantaneous there, because what happened there, we say because of that carrier, so what happened that a current pulse will be maximum, okay, that current pulse will be maximum, and at that particular junction, okay, this is about what you can say, I'll just draw a diagram there, so you get the idea about what happened to the field here. So this is about, we say, a figure, it will explain you that about the current pulses at the particular junction while applying the bias voltage. So this is about your bias voltage. That is, we say it's about a 400 kV. And we can say that about a DC applied plus RF voltage. This one is about a RF voltage we apply. Okay. When we apply the RF voltage, that will be above that particular DC voltage. Okay, so this is about our DC voltage plus RF applied by. This one is about a peak here. Okay, changes. Now, this is about if current pulses now. Here the maximum current occurs. This one we say is about a maximum current occurs. Then another pulse is about what we say here now. So likewise, this is the current pulse maximum here. When we say that V is equal to 0, and this one is about a current pulse at a cathode when we say that V will become say maximum there. So these are about the current pulse. Here we can say that about this one is about a current pulse, and this one we say that about a current pulse drift to the cathode. Okay, so this is about, you can say it is about a current pulse, and this one is about a time here, variation with respect to time, because we say that RF AC voltage that will be superimposed on the whatever the high DC voltage. This is about a high DC voltage, this is nothing but a RF voltage. And what happened when we have that positive cycle? This is about a positive RF cycle. So in that case, when this voltage will be exceeding to this particular positive half cycle, then what happened? That avalanche current multiplication takes place, and then that is about nothing but particular period of time, and this particular multiplication process, or can say that avalanche, that it will not be instantaneous, but a current pulses of a maximum current pulses at that junction occurs. This is about a current pulse will occur at the particular junction there. When it will occur, because that shift, whatever the phase, or we can say that is about the phase difference of a 90 degree. So I'll just draw here, that is about a phase degree of a phase difference of a 90 degree. This one is about a phase difference of a 90 degree. This is about your DC, as well as you can see that is about the what we have applied the voltage, and this is called as a avalanche. And what will be the frequency we say? It is about Vd by I shall tell you about the whatever the length of the drift space region, or you can say that about the charge region. And we say that VD is nothing but the carrier drift velocity. This one we say, okay, so that's about this one we say is about a carrier drift velocity. Carry drift velocity, and this L, L is nothing but what? A length of the drift space region. Okay, drift space region. Okay, that is about your length, and this one is about your V. So now, if you see this particular figure, so there is about a phase difference between the voltage and current. That has been okay because of that particular 90 degree of a phase here. So so likewise we say that about it. When it will occur, so it will be beyond that particular RF voltage. Now we say that that is about a current pulse. That is a current pulse when we have that maximum value of V is equal to zero. And current pulse at cathode when V is equal to max. So that because of this one, we say that your current pulse at a cathode when we have the V is equal to max means we say that generally we say that that current pulse move toward the cathode. Okay, when the means we say that about current pulse move toward the cathode. But it is not actually we say. Current pulses is moving toward the cathode region. But that pulse will reach to the cathode, and that it is when it will reach to the cathode, it is depending upon that how much is the voltage. So that is we can say that is about the V max. We say it is about the V max. So and again it will be depending upon that what will be the length of that particular drift region, or you can say that that particular material we are using and what will be the thickness of that particular material, or we say that what will be the thickness of that of what will be the material we are using. So this one we say that is about the N plus, means N plus means what? It is about the highly doped, okay, highly doped N plus layer. So what will be the thickness of that particular highly doped N plus layer? According to that current pulse, or you can say that current pulse will reach to this particular cathode, and that will be the time taken by this particular pulse, current pulse, to reach to the cathode. And that particular time we can consider that we can say that a multiplication time. Okay, that we can say that is about the avalanche multiplication process takes place at that particular time. If we adjust the what will be the dopant, or you can say that is about the thickness of that particular layer, so then we can say that whatever the time taken for the particular pulse to move from what V is equal to 0 to V plus max, okay, it will be changes, it will be decreases, or it will be increased according to the whatever the thickness we are using. So the total, if you consider that, the total voltage and current here right now, it is about the 180 degree out of phase, because this device will work, because we say that is about out of phase here, right? We say earlier here, the device will work in the negative resistance region because the current and voltage is about a 90 degree, and similarly we have say that transit time effect. A current and voltage will be delayed and with a 90 degree of a phase. Same thing is occurring. So that is about 180 degree phase shift, and your device will work in a negative resistance region. So impact diode, as compared to the gun diode, if you consider impact diode is again used as an oscillator, or you can use this impact diode as an amplifier. This is about we say impact diode. Application we say we it can work as an oscillator, or we can use as a amplifier. So both the way we can consider that is about the impaired diode, and that resonant frequency of this particular diode, that is nothing but it is equal to, we say F is equal to what, Vd by twice L. That Vd, we say it is about a carrier drift velocity. And this particular length is about the length of the drift space region. Okay, this is about the length of this drift space region. So that is about a impaired diode. Now we see the construction of that impaired diode, how we can construct that a impaired diode. See the construction of an impaired diode. How it looks like there at the bottom. How we can construct that impaired diode and all. We'll learn here. At the bottom, we can say SCU cathode. So this one is about a gold wire. One can see that CU cathode seal we have here, ceramic case. This one is about is, we say, anode that is to be connected to the external heat sink. And if you see this one, this particular portion of this particular diode, so it looks like what? So this is about is sent here. Okay, likewise, you see, the portion will be likewise. And okay, so this one is about a portion. Okay, so you can see that is about a portion. So in that case, this will be a N plus, this will be a N, and this will be a P plus region. And this is about, you can say, it is connected to the gold wire. And this particular portion is called as a gold alloy. And this is about, you can say, it is about the impaired diode. And next, we see that is about a trapped diode.